So I was wondering if I should get dressed up for my interview with Matt Gerard. I mean, look at me. I'm in my Carhartt and stuff. And look at the dude.
Where's my Carhartt? Well, it's kind of like that. We kind of match in.
Yeah, what's happening, brother?
How you doing? Sorry, I slept through that interview.
That's okay. No, you were good.
I'm so sorry.
You were good.
I got your voicemail. I was like, oh, no.
It could happen.
I slept through that.
Yeah. Hey, so it's interesting. I was talking to Gonzo, and he said that it was a number of years ago that you were auditioning for American Idol in this very house. And Gonzo was a judge.
Yeah.
And you got third, I guess?
Yeah, exactly. There wasn't like a place, but we'd stay around second.
Sure. And he says to this day you would remember his words as a judge, possibly sage advice.
He said too runny.
Too runny? Really?
Mm-hmm. He wrote that. I don't remember.
Gonzo knows piano enough to say too runny.
I didn't play piano. I just kind of sang. But I was like, whoa. I was just nervous and young and I wasn't ready yet, but he'd call me too runny, and I watched it back, and he was right.
You were trembling like a little schoolgirl.
Like a little schoolgirl.
So here you are coming back now, Mac Daddy. I mean, you got to be nervous still, because look at it.
Matt Daddy.
This is a big house.
Matt Daddy.
Mac Daddy. You're the Mac Daddy, no longer the runny person.
No, well, I'm still runny, yeah. But not as much.
Yeah, but I mean, are you nervous?
Not really, man. I mean, this is, you know, we played Idol Tour. We played like 13,000 people a night. You know?
Oh, that's
so
true.
I got the nerves out of me. You know? Now it's just like I'm really excited. Like I feel like almost like everyone's coming over to my house and I'm gonna play some songs for them. You know, that's what it feels like.
That's fun. And now, do you have a ritual backstage before you go on? I mean, do you do like push-ups, sit-ups, go Zen? What do you do?
I don't, you know, I try not to make it too epic. You know, like some people like listen to a certain song, get all pumped up, but I just want to like relax and just laugh, talk to my friends, and you know, if I treat it like it's just another night, then I can perform the most comfortably, I think.
Yeah, because you can't be all tense when you're playing the piano, probably.
You know, some people are probably like all epic, like I think about my whole life before I sing, you know.
Right.
Imagine all the performances and stuff.
Yeah, well, you know, we were just talking to some folks over here, and they said, what's cool about you is you're just so natural. You haven't been hit by the star bug yet, where you all of a sudden change the way you are. I mean, what causes that in people, do you think? Can you ever see a day when you're going to think, you're better than this, and now I have to behave differently? I mean, is there a trigger in the world of stars that makes that happen?
I mean, there's a, you know, to a certain extent, you know, you gotta have a standard for yourself, you know? Mm-hmm. So it's not like I think I'm better than anyone, I just think I've had, you know, more exposure than some.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like, the thing is, you gotta remember, I was the same person, the same musician. I've grown a little bit, but I was the same person a year and a half ago.
Sure.
And I didn't have all these people coming to see me, you know what I mean?
Right.
So, you know, there's something changed there, and it was a, you know, what I did on Idol, you know. So I don't think of myself as like, yeah, I made this, you know. I like,
right.
You know, my songs, you know, anything. It's not like that, you know.
Yeah.
So maybe in a couple of years after I had a couple of albums out, maybe I'll be a little more proud of my musical.
Well, you should be very proud of what you've accomplished. I mean, because think of it. Here, a number of years ago, auditioning for Idol, going back to the piano place in Kalamazoo, playing your heart out, thinking maybe one day it'll happen. Then it does happen, and now you're just on the leading edge of what could be just a major career.
Yeah, it's like a dream, you know, and like the chances are, you know, I know most idols, you know, a lot of them fall off, but
right.
The thing is with me, I'm on the way to keeping going because I write a lot and I'm working with like some of the top producers and writers in the country, and that's not a bad place to be,
right?
Because I'm making some good music that I feel like I'm developing a little arsenal, you know, I got it in my coat and I'm going to let it out to the world soon.
Well, and look at like Kara on Idol at this point, because, you know, I mean, she's a songwriter.
Yeah.
Right? And, yeah. I mean, you can make a great living just being a songwriter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you're double-edged talent here.
A lot of these writers I play with, they still play shows all the time. And they have songs that they've written that you don't know about, you know?
Yeah.
So it's a cool life.
Yeah, and lastly, I think it's very cool that you associate yourself primarily with buds, right? I mean, people that you came up through at in college in Kalamazoo. I mean, your manager is, what, a former roommate?
Yeah, my managers are still out in 19, 19 management out in, you know, okay. LA, stuff like that. But yeah, like my assistant and like my assistants and like all the people that help me out are, you know, old friends of mine that are just, you know, great. They do it great, you know.
Yeah.
You know.
That's great. I mean, I think that's very cool.
Yeah.
All righty, man, I'll tell you what. Can you say one thing for me?
Yes.
Okay, think about it. Your memory. I just say, I'm a musician. I don't get up early enough to listen to Barnaby and Friends. But if I did get up that early, I'd certainly be tuning in.
Okay.
Something along those lines.
I'm a lazy blues musician.
Yeah, whatever you want to say.
I'm a musician. I don't wake up early enough to listen to Barnaby and Friends, but if I did, I definitely would be tuning in because they got it going on.